Now, industrial policy, by its very nature, involves state involvement in directing economic activity. It involves activist involvement of the public sector in causing economic actors to go in a direction they would otherwise have not gone. Now that means to talk of a trade-led industrial policy is to talk of a contradiction. The idea that the market can direct people outside where they wanted to, outside where they make money in the short run, into a direction that makes long-term developmental sense is a contradiction in terms. Which is why I am proposing the title of the myth. It's a myth to talk of trade leadership, to talk of market guidance of industrial policy. And I will argue that to adopt the continent-wide free trade agreements, to adopt free trade agreements in general, and assume that they will deliver us from an agrarian economic structure in an era of economic openness is to sleepwalk into a disaster. Can Africa, as the IMF World Bank claim, can Africa trade its way out of poverty? And if we did that, then the question is, trade in what? How can you trade your way out of poverty before you create the wealth that will compete and match with the best and brightest? The key driver of free trade agreements today is integration in the global markets. But to integrate means you're exposing yourself to the forces of competition. And therefore, it requires preparation. None of today's high-tech economies, none of today's most effective competitors industrialized in the context of free markets. All, with the possible exception of Switzerland, insulated their domestic farms from harmful external competition. When they were ready, they started competition, even then gradually. Whether we are talking of Britain, the so-called first industrializer, whether we are talking of USA, whether we're talking of Japan, whether we're talking of Germany, or the catch-up economies of East Asia, all insulated the economies. So the question should not be whether we should protect or not. The question is how. We all know that we can't do without trade, certainly. But we can negotiate and or postpone free trade until we are ready.
The critique that we are having in the era of globalization is about free trade. The idea that you must liberalize your trade and let everything come in. But a free trade is not contemptuous with trade. To say that you are against free trade is not to say you are against trade. Because production in a modern society is the production of commodities. You produce to sell. Because we don't produce to consume. And therefore, to be a successful producer, you must have a market, either local market or foreign market. Trade is necessary.
Yeah.
So even an agricultural farmer needs trade.
Exactly.
So for Africa, what we need is a market for ourselves, which allows us to build our capacity for ourselves while we explore the possibilities of exporting ourselves.
We need to learn from the German through what they call Staatsbildung. Staatsbildung in English is loosely translated as state building. In German it's more serious. Staatsbildung in German means shifting from liberalism, economic liberalism, to economic nationalism as a key driver, as a key ideology driving wealth creation. There is no way you can construct economic transformation without a change in ideology. If the key actors in the Continental Free Trade Agreement are neoliberal actors, you cannot expect an ideology that promotes long-term development. Under the Staatsbildung strategy of Germany, proven successful across the world, is to build meritocratic institutions such as MITI in Japan, the Ministry for International Trade and Industry in Japan. In Uganda, we had the Uganda Development Corporation, a meritocratic institution, which was the captain of investment, the captain of an entrepreneurial state in this country. So that is a strategy we need to work. And finally, we need to adopt smart industrial policy. Smart industrial policy is also the way we should take, because it says, look, government, you cannot fold hands. Government can be a market. Through your procurement, even if they are restricting WTO rules, through your procurement as government, you can actually say, I am going to purchase all the equipment, all the textiles of the National Army and Police Force from the local manufacturing firm. Trade is of two varieties. There is trade that fits in the arena of orthodox trade policies. And there is trade that is organically integrated with industrial policy. This is called strategic trade. The other one is orthodox trade. This is heterodox, because it is rethinking conventional wisdom and proposing alternatives. Now, when you say that all of us, Africa needs trade, I would invite you to say that what Africa needs is not orthodox trade, because this promotes trade based on your natural advantages. Orthodox trade says it's okay to export no value-added products. Orthodox trade will say domestic industry is not a priority. If you can have any company sell your products to you at an affordable price, it's okay. Strategic trade disagrees. So strategic trade, which is what we need, says that we need politically constructed competitive advantages. That the state has a strategic role to play in the economy in guiding leading sectors, so that even if we started by exporting what we have, that is a short-term measure. Over the long term, we must produce and export things of high value. When we talk of trade-led industrial policies, we are critiquing this, the orthodox variant, and saying what we need is the strategic variant, which would involve controls regulating FDIs. My point is that we need to appreciate that the current orthodoxy emphasizing neoliberal trade is an orthodoxy that is unlikely to deliver structural socio-economic transformation. We cannot industrialize in the current discourse. What we need is the alternative. Strategic trade, which is tied with industrial policy.
Trade cannot lead to neutralization, but trade has a role in neutralization if you conceive it in a particular way. So if you put these two questions together, what role can trade be conceptualized in an industrial program in Africa, so that when we come to negotiate a continental free trade agreement, we can have one that is responsible?